The Laguna Copper Plate. The plate was found in 1989 by a laborer near the mouth of the Lumbang River in Wawa, Lumban, Laguna in the Philippines. The inscription was written in Old Malay using the Kawi script, the Sanskrit, and Old Japanese influences. After its discovery, its text was first translated in 1991 by Anton Postma, a Dutch anthropologist and Hanunu script researcher. The inscription documents the existence and name of several contemporaneous neighboring states such as the city-states of Tondo. Some historians suggest that this implies economic, cultural, and political connection between these states, as well as with the contemporaneous Medang Kingdom in Java due to its explicit mention in the inscription.
The History of Laguna Copper Plate Inscription. The Laguna Copper Plate is a thin piece of blackened metal that was purchased by the National Museum of the Philippines in 1990 after the former owner failed to find a private buyer. Following a careful examination of the plate, it was found to be a 90 centimeter square copper plate cover one side by a 10 line inscription of finely written characters. Unable to disappear it themselves, the museum gave the text of Dutch anthropologist Anton Postma, who was based in the Philippines with his Filipino wife, to analyze. Prior to the disappearing of text on the Laguna Copper Plate, historians had almost universally accepted that the history of the Philippines only dated back to 1521, when records had noted to a rival Magellan and Chronicle, Antonia Figafetta, on the archipelago. Before this, there had been very little history recorded in a way that would have allowed it to survive. As such, the landmark discovery of the Laguna Copper Plate pushed back the start of Filipino history by 600.
The inscription shows heavy Sanskrit and old Japanese linguistic influences. Among the observations made by Antonio Pigafetta in the 16th century Boxer Codex was that old Malay had currency among its classical period, Filipinos as a lingua franca. The golden Tara statue, an ancient artifact discovered in Butuan, Agusan del Norte, dates from the same period and strongly suggests the presence of Hindu-Buddhist beliefs prior to the introduction to Roman Catholicism and Islam among Filipinos.
Origins of the inscription on the Laguna Copper Plate. The inscription on the surviving copper plate is in itself intriguing and has provided enough material for scholars to analyze. For instance, the type of script used in the Laguna Copper Plate inscription has been identified as the so-called Early Kawi script, a writing system that originated in the Indonesian island of Java and was used across much of maritime Southeast Asia during the 10th century AD. In fact, this script is said to have been derived from the Palawa script, which has its origin in India. As for the language of the inscription, it has been found to be heavily influenced linguistically by Sanskrit, Old Malay, and Old Javanese. Both the typescript and the language of the Laguna Copper Plate inscription, therefore, shows that this area was not actually isolated from the rest of Southeast Asia as had been previously assumed. The inscription begins by providing a date, hail in the Saka year 822, the month of March to April, according to the astronomer, the fourth day of the dark half of the moon on Monday. The Saka era has its origin in India, supposedly marking the ascension of the Kushan Emperor Kanishka, and the year 822 is said to correspond with the year 980 in the Gregorian calendar. The use of this calendrical system is further evidence that there were cultural links between this area of Southeast Asia and its neighbors, which at that time were largely under the cultural influence of India. As for the subject matter of the Laguna Copper Plate, description, it has been suggested that the inscription is a semi-official certificate of acquittal of a death incurred by a person in high office, together with his whole family, all relatives, and descendants.
The Laguna Copper Plate inscription was found in 1989 near the mouth of the Lumbang River, near Laguna de Bay, by a man who was dredging sand to turn into concrete, suspecting that the artifact might have some value. The man sold it to an antique dealer, having found no buyers, eventually sold it to the National Museum of the Philippines, where it was assigned to Alfredo Evangelista, head of its anthropology department. The National Museum refers to the artifact as the Laguna Copper Plate.
Based on stone tools that have been recovered during archaeological excavation, the history of man in the Philippines can be considered to have started at least 400 years ago. Since that early starting point, a variety of human remains, tools and artificial, is still being excavated, testify to a consistent human habitation of the Philippine archipelago and its social interact and trade.
The Laguna Copper Plate proves that the natives of Philippines were already connected to other Asian cultures long before Spanish colonization. It mentions places in Luzon such as Tondo, Pila, Bisruta, Binwagan, places in Mindo such as Diwata, and also Medang on the island of Java in Indonesia. It also uses the Kawi script, which was first used in Java. It mentions name of people, mostly the leader of the mentioned places above. Lastly, a date using the old Hindu calendar is also written on the copper plate.